In this part, we'll discuss about all the phases of menstrual cycle in detail and the changes which take place. So, I'm writing it here because we need the entire board to understand. Now, let us see where all these changes are going to take place. So, we'll divide this into various parts. Here, we will be drawing the uterine wall. So, changes which take place in the uterine wall, we'll draw those here. Then, the next thing that we need to discuss are the hormones. So, here we will talk about or see the levels of ovarian hormones. Then, in this part, we'll try to see what change takes place in the ovary itself. So here, changes in ovary. And here is the pituitary gland and its hormones. So we have divided everything into different areas so that simultaneously we are able to understand what are the changes which are taking place. And below this, we'll write down the name of the phase. So, the first phase that we are talking of here is the menstrual phase. Menstrual phase. What exactly happens during menstrual phase is the endometrial lining is lost. And this is known as menstruation. So, here, menstruation is taking place, and this takes place when the progesterone level is very, very low. Progesterone is the hormone which is produced from the corpus luteum. So here we will use a particular color to represent progesterone. Say this represents progesterone level. This is the lowest level of progesterone. So if progesterone level is low, it is not able to maintain the thick endometrium. So when progesterone level falls, the endometrial lining is lost in the form of menstruation. Now this low progesterone level, let us have this dotted line here, which is going to help us understand what exactly is happening. Now this low level of progesterone, so we'll write it here, low progesterone. Low level of progesterone is going to stimulate pituitary gland to increase the secretion of FSH. What is it doing? It is stimulates to increase secretion of FSH. And because of this, now pituitary starts to produce FSH, that is follicle stimulating hormone. So what has happened so far in the first 4 to 5 days, that is in the menstrual phase, the endometrial lining is lost. Why is the lining lost? Because the progesterone level was low. When progesterone level is minimum, that is at this time, that low progesterone level stimulates the anterior lobe of pituitary to increase the production of FSH. So now FSH is produced. FSH is follicle stimulating hormone. So now when this follicle stimulating hormone is produced in the ovary, those follicle clusters which are there, out of which one primary follicle starts to grow. It becomes bigger and finally, it is going to change into the Graafian follicle. So here we have this Graafian follicle form under the influence of FSH. And that is follicle stimulating. So follicle stimulating hormone brings about these changes. Let us go over it one more time. Beginning of the cycle starts with menstruation. Endometrial lining is lost due to low level of progesterone. So this green line, this is representing progesterone. Here the level is minimum. Low level has stimulated the pituitary gland to produce FSH. As soon as FSH is produced, these follicles in the ovary, they start to grow. And now here we have seen this graafian follicle form. Follicles start to produce hormone. Follicles are going to secrete their hormone, which is known as estrogen. So here the estrogen level is going to increase. So this red line is representing the estrogen level. Estrogen level increases because the follicles are growing. Follicles are growing because of FSH. Now, because of this estrogen, what is the chain that has taken place in the endometrial lining? This endometrium was scrapped off. It has to repair itself. So now this endometrial lining starts to repair. It becomes thick and folded. So this is endometrium. It becomes about 2 to 3 millimeters thick and glandular. The glands are formed which are going to produce the secretion. This phase is under the influence of the follicles, and that is why this phase is known as the follicular phase. Up till here, it will be called follicular phase. Because the primary follicle is growing, the follicles are producing the hormone, and these hormones are bringing about the changes. At this level, the thickening has gone up till here, the estrogen level is high. At this level, say here, again I draw a dotted line, the estrogen level is high. So this high estrogen level, high estrogen, is going to stimulate pituitary gland. It is going to stimulate pituitary gland. Stimulate to do what? To decrease the secretion of FSH and increase the secretion of LH. Why FSH secretion should go down? Because now one secondary oocyte has developed. This is going to change into egg. No new development should take place because the female's body is designed in such a manner that it can perfectly hold only one embryo. So no new follicle should be formed. No new egg should be formed. That's why FSH production should stop. So this high estrogen stimulates pituitary to decrease the secretion of FSH and increase LH production. So now from pituitary gland, LH, luteinizing hormone, is released. This luteinizing hormone is responsible for ovulation. That means now this graafian follicle is going to rupture, releasing the secondary oocyte. This takes place on the 14th day. This is the 14th day, and this is known as ovulation. So here, ovulation is taking place. At this point, level of LH, luteinizing hormone, is maximum. So if we just show the luteinizing hormone, its level is high here, very high. It is high here. So high LH is known as LH surge. So this tip is called LH surge. When LH level is very, very high, and that is responsible for ovulation. So what has happened from the graafian follicle? Let me write it here. This is graafian follicle. The egg has been released, and now this structure is going to change into corpus luteum. Corpus luteum formation. And for formation of corpus luteum, LH is again required. So here this graafian follicle has changed into this corpus luteum. This corpus luteum is going to produce progesterone. So let us go back to this progesterone level here. This was low, slight increase here. Here also it is same. And once the corpus luteum is formed, the progesterone level increases. Under the influence of high progesterone level, this endometrial lining, it undergoes further foldings and it becomes even thicker. It becomes about 5 millimeters thick. And this phase, because this is taking place under the influence of progesterone, which is secreted from corpus luteum, it is known as luteal phase. This corpus luteum is going to remain if fertilization takes place. So, if this corpus luteum stays, progesterone level will remain high throughout the 9 months of gestation period. But if there is no fertilization, on 14th day, the egg is released. Egg remains in the fallopian tube for 2 days. If it gets fertilized within those 2 days, fertilization will take place, corpus luteum will persist. If fertilization does not take place, then this corpus luteum is going to change into corpus albicans. It becomes degenerate, or it starts to degenerate. If it starts to degenerate, then in that case, progesterone level will fall and it will come to this minimum again. So this is high progesterone level, progesterone, if fertilization takes place. And here we write that progesterone level decreases in case of no fertilization. If there is no fertilization, this level is going to again fall down. When it comes to this low level, again, this thick endometrial lining will not be maintained. And this lining will again be lost in the form of the menstrual flow. So we have divided the complete thing into 4 parts. The first 4 to 5 days, menstrual phase. Next 10 to 12 days are known as the follicular phase. 1 day of ovulation or ovulatory phase. And after that is the luteal phase. So there are changes which are taking place in the endometrium of the uterus. There are changes in the hormones which are produced from the ovarian follicles, and there is a stimulation to produce some hormones, decrease certain hormones from the pituitary gland. So it is a self-regulating system where the hormone levels increase and decrease. And these changes make the female, or prepares the female for fertilization and implantation. Why this kind of endometrium is required? Because if fertilization takes place, then the zygote will get fixed into one of these depressions, and then chorionic villi formation, placenta formation would take place. But if there is no fertilization, then this endometrial lining, or this thick endometrial lining, is not required. So here it became thick under the influence of estrogen. It becomes even thicker, vascular, under the influence of progesterone. And as soon as progesterone level declines below a limit, this lining cannot be maintained. And that's when it is lost in the form of the menstrual flow. And this is the easiest way to understand menstrual cycle, because we are able to correlate all changes which are taking place at different levels, the hormone levels also, in the organs also. So this is the menstrual cycle, which is a characteristic feature of human females and primates. It perfectly, if it goes in that theoretical manner, then it gets completed in 28 days. But it is variable in